when life just kind of not keeps knocking him down, and there he goes. Nope, yeah, he's not going to accept it. He's just not going to accept it.
At first glance, you can see it. Garrett Choate is a football player.
It was always a dream to play for SMU.
The son of an SMU legend, Putt Choate still holds the school record for most tackles. He went on to play in the USFL and the NFL. But there's more to Garrett.
It's not your typical
than meets the eye
comeback story.
In sixth grade, Garrett broke a bone in his lower back while playing football.
Several doctors said that I was never going to play any sport again.
Devastating news for a multi-sport athlete.
You tell that kid he can't, and he's going to do it.
Garrett spent a year in a back brace. Then after consulting with another doctor, he adhered to a strict rehab plan and was eventually cleared to play.
By far the most happiest day of my life.
Garrett became an all-state player at Parish Episcopal High School, but the physical talent masked the mental struggles Garrett endured for years.
It was kind of difficult for me to understand.
As a child, Garrett was diagnosed with severe anxiety and obsessive compulsive disorder, OCD.
The best way to describe it is just an overwhelming feeling that if you don't do this task, whatever it is, something bad will happen.
As symptoms worsened, Garrett was prescribed Luvox. He took the pills for nearly a decade. With no Division I offers out of high school, Garrett walked on at Utah. But his mind and body started to shut down. Doctors recommended Garrett take an expensive drug gene test.
Our insurance wouldn't even pay for it.
The results showed that Luvox was toxic for Garrett's genetic makeup.
The recommended usage for Luvox in the first place is no longer than 30 days, and I'd been on it for about 9 years.
You look back and you think, oh gee, I should have known as a parent. That's the thing that you beat yourself up the most. You didn't check, you didn't look, you weren't aware.
Garrett's mother Fifi moved out to Utah for a couple months to help Garrett come off the medication gradually. But one morning, Garrett felt sick and could not digest the pills that day.
It was just a nightmare, laying on the bathroom floor thinking I'm about to die.
It was the most frightening thing I've ever been through. He was so violently ill.
I threw up 24 times in about 12 hours. The doctor said it was similar to like a heroin addict going through a complete cold turkey detox. One day off of this stuff has me going through hell.
He got through it. Garrett eventually weaned off the drug, moved home to Dallas, stuck to a strict nutrition plan, and walked on to his father's alma mater.
Most people would have quit, and I don't think anybody would have blamed him.
He's a warrior. The kid's a warrior. He takes a beating and he gets back up.
Now Garrett sees the benefit to sharing his story for others.
He doesn't want another child to go through the hell that he had to go through.
It took me a while to see that it could help people, you know, and that it would be selfish not to share it.
In Dallas, I'm Jonah Javad.